说到好莱坞对亚裔角色的塑造，那可是有不少让观众失望的黑历史。
Aloha, where Emma Stone is playing a part Chinese person. Ghost in the Shell, where Scarlett Johansson is playing Major Motoko Kusanagi. Tilda Swinton playing the Ancient One, who was traditionally a Tibetan character.
于是，对于漫威的第一个亚裔超级英雄上汽登上大荧幕，许多影迷，尤其是亚裔美国人，不敢抱有太多的期待。
I had very little expectations coming in. You know, give me some good fight scenes, some humor here and there. Don't offend me too much.Much and don't bore me, and I'll enjoy the film.
那在看完上期之后，亚裔美国人对这部电影的真实看法到底如何呢？上汽打破了多个记录，他有着漫威第一个以亚裔和亚裔美国人为主的演员阵容，编剧和导演也是亚裔美国人。他成为了2020年和2021年美国本土票房最高的电影，他还是烂番茄上评分最高的漫威电影之一。
For me, I walked out having my expectations really surpassed. Wow, they really nailed it. From the little things of, you know, taking off your shoes, having like kanji with your family in the morning, really just having your parents kind of like pepper you about what you're doing with your life.
Really amazing fight scenes, bits of humor that show how Asian Americans are fully developed humans, not just stereotypical tropes. I actually really enjoyed it.
上汽受到大力好评的一个原因是它打破了美国社会过去对亚洲人和亚裔的刻板印象。
The representations of Chinese laborers in the late 19th century is connected to kind of fears aboutimmigration and taking over jobs. Representations of Japanese Americans and Japanese are connected to, you know, World War II anti-miscegenation laws that prevent Asians on some level representing themselves on television and movies, which led to the practice of yellowface.
对于很多亚裔来说，这些刻板印象困扰着他们。
Not having a lot of representation, not a lot of Asian American role models growing up, I think for me, really affected how I saw myself. I think it really reflected my self-esteem, it really affected my mental health, it really affected my confidence, my ability to relate to my parents.
William 非常渴望能在大荧幕上看到更多亚洲人主演的电影，这给了他一个灵感。他用 Photoshop 把热门电影的大男主换成了韩裔演员 John Cho， 并发起了 Starring John Cho 这个话题。
If you actually saw John Cho as Captain America, if you saw John Cho as James Bond, it doesn't look that weird. If anything, it actually looks really normal. And it should, because Asian people are humans who can play multifaceted people just like anybody else can.
Starring John Cho 在网络上的走红让 William 意识到大家都渴望能够在好莱坞看到更多的亚裔面孔。而在另一方面，亚裔网红文化的兴起也让好莱坞开始反思。
Audiences, particularly Asian American audiences and neutral audiences were flocking to these types of places for types of stories and representations that they were not getting elsewhere. Hollywood and mainstream television media industries were like, well, we're losing viewership. We need to rethink how we're going to connect with that.
所以上汽能搬上大荧幕，可能真的是一个天时地利人和的结果。不过呢，一个有趣的现象是，演员刘思慕和 Awkwafina 现在在美国都是大红大紫，但是他们的外表在中国的社交媒体上得到了非常两极化的评论，尤其是主演刘思慕。由此 ，Professor Fam 在课堂上做了一个小调查，他让两个班级的学生来选择刘思慕和肖战到底谁更好看。
Both my classes, were completely opposite. One class was like, "Simu is really attractive because typifies masculine features," and the other person, like, "Well, we like the other person's style, his aura, which is much more probably in line with K-pop, right?" A lot of my students are very into, or at least aware of K-pop, BTS, and that kind of measure of attractiveness.
I find it interesting that if you are to be someone who is saving the day, you somehow have to be also extremely good-looking and validate many different cultures' ideas and notions of what their beauty standards are. I think there's an opportunity to take a new lens to that conversation and really question why that matters so much, that someone's notion of beauty is the number one indicator of whether or not we would want to watch them in a movie.
就在过去的短短几年里，好莱坞涌现了不少围绕亚裔的影视作品。
I believe that Hollywood and other media industries are beginning to recognize that.If Asian American audiences do not like the type of things that are putting out, they will respond accordingly and let others know about it. And that provides another point of leverage, which wasn't possible 30, 40 years ago.
What I'm really excited about is getting to the point where we start seeing really goofy Asian characters, weird Asian characters, fun Asian characters that, you know, come from a variety of different genders, sexualities, backgrounds, upbringings, classes. To me, I can't wait for that next era of stories that we're able to kind of see ourselves in.
Hello, 谢谢你收看到这里。那你看了上汽吗？你喜欢这部片子吗？你对这部片子的感觉如何？欢迎在评论区里告诉我们。那如果你喜欢这个视频，也记得点赞转发。我们下期视频再见，拜拜。